Avengers Endgame is right around the corner, and a lot of the new footage has led people to believe that the Avengers, along with Captain Marvel, will go fight the Mad Titan very early on in this movie. But we see them on Earth later, and they are seemingly unscathed. This would mean that they might actually beat Thanos. In this video, I want to explain to you how Thanos could die before we even see the title sequence of Endgame.
We do it for the fans.
This video was created in part by executive producer Al Schuler. What's up, everybody? I'm Josh. This is the Den of Nerds. Buckle in for this crazy theory video, but I do want to give a slight spoiler warning. I don't think we're touching on anything here that hasn't been discussed in other videos or, you know, other places online, but if you want to go into Endgame completely none the wiser about anything that could happen, skip off of this video because we might get some of this stuff right and we are going to talk about other leaks and spoilers. All right, so let's get into this. Now, we are pretty dang sure that the Avengers are going to go fight Thanos very early on in the film. A lot of this is coming from the footage and the scenes that were shown first to Disney shareholders and then more recently to people at CinemaCon. This scene is all about the Avengers at the Avengers facility with Captain Marvel trying to figure out what their next move is. And Captain Marvel really wants to just go fight Thanos, and the other Avengers are not so sure about this, but they end up going. In the CinemaCon footage, we see Captain America literally say, "Let's go get this son of a bitch," and then they cut to the shots of all of them on the Benatar with Rocket. Now, when we see them in this shot in the Benatar, we can see that this is Natasha with her short hair, and this is Steve Rogers in his uniform that he wore in Infinity War. Unless this shot is being digitally altered, this really hints at the Avengers indeed tracking down Thanos at the Garden and confronting him very early on in the movie. The thing about that is, though, we see these characters on Earth with a major time passing. This is Natasha with her long, long red hair, and even Steve Rogers with his longer hair. I mean, there's been a long passing of time. And so if they're back on Earth, but they do fight him at the beginning of the film, there's only one explanation for that, and that would be that they actually beat him. And given the stakes, and given how pissed off everybody is, I expect them to go at him hard as nails. I don't think they're going to take him prisoner. I think they're going to kill him. Now, the craziest part of this is even if they do defeat him, it does not undo the snap. We also know that Thanos and the gauntlet are both permanently damaged after doing the snap. And so if the Avengers with Captain Marvel show up and they have that kind of power and Thanos is truly weakened, it's very possible that they actually do defeat him. Perhaps in some last-ditch effort to make sure that the snap stays permanently done, Thanos could then destroy all of the Infinity Stones. And then the Avengers would really be left with pretty much nothing. They'd go back to Earth. And I think this would actually explain a lot of the shots we see in the trailers. There's seemingly this long passing of time where the characters are trying to move on. We see Captain America at one of these meetings for people that have survived the decimation. We even hear Captain America say something to the effect of some people move on. I keep telling people that they should move on, but not us. Well, how's he gonna be on Earth interacting and telling people to move on if he goes to fight Thanos in the beginning? It would be that he goes there, they beat him, and it still doesn't change anything. They have to go back to Earth with their tail between their legs, and maybe they avenged Earth because they defeated Thanos, but that's not good enough. That's not a victory. Half of the universe is still gone. Now, I think very important to this theory would be the fact that Tony Stark would never give up. He would never accept what had happened with the snap. And there are a couple of reasons why. Number one, because Doctor Strange explained the one scenario and Doctor Strange traded the time stone for Tony Stark's life. Also, the fact that Thanos knew who Stark was, that Stark had literally been having visions of Thanos since the Battle of New York. And so in this scenario, the Avengers without Tony would go beat Thanos, come back to Earth, try to move on. Tony would then be working on his plan, and when he got it to the point where he thought he could share with everybody, he would then bring it to the Avengers, and then they would go then recruit Ronan, try to get everybody on the same page, and then go into the Quantum Realm. Now, the majority of the conflict of the film, considering that Thanos would be gone, would have to come from the Avengers going through the Quantum Realm and revisiting classic moments from the MCU's history where the Infinity Stones were present. And we already know they're doing at least one of these, and that would be the Battle of New York, and they're likely going to be fighting in that battle. This would tie into the OG plot leak, to the most popular fan theory that is out there, and this is the Ant-Man Quantum Realm suits Quantum Realm travel, time travel theory. Then we would see Thanos in his armor with the sword without any of the stones, but with the full might of his army, and he would be absolutely hell-bent on getting those stones and using whatever force was necessary to do so. And in this way, the Avengers would have a second chance at fighting off Thanos, but also he'd be out for blood this time, which would cause a lot of devastation. This would explain why we see Thanos with the sword and the armor, and we don't really see any shots of the Infinity Gauntlet in any of the trailers. Now, there's a very popular theory on Reddit right now that talks about this scenario, but it says that then Thanos would meet Mistress Death in the Soul World or in the Realm of Death, and he would be watching as the Avengers did all of these things and gathered the stones, and then he would sort of beg her to allow him to go back and stop them from undoing the snap. Now, I gotta admit, I don't think that's gonna happen. I don't think they're gonna introduce Mistress Death at all, but they've already introduced a scenario that is very similar to this. This is with Gamora in the Soul World. And so if they go and beat Thanos very early on in the movie, he could just be chilling in the Soul World with Gamora talking to her, and that would allow him to possibly watch what was going on with the Avengers. Now, another way that this could happen is if they show up to Titan 2, fight Thanos in the garden, they beat him, and then all of the stones and Thanos just dissolve. They're gone forever. Or at least we think. Then the Avengers just leave, go back to Earth, and they're like, okay, we beat Thanos, but it's not good enough. And Thanos on Titan 2 just literally re-manifests himself, meaning they might go there and beat him, and then they leave, and he just comes back because he's like, whatever, I can't die. I've got the Soul Stone, so whatever, guys. That would explain all of the events that I just took you guys through, like the reason that they're all unmaimed and alive still on Earth, the reason that they're moving on or they think they have to move on, and then the reason that Tony Stark convinces them that no, they don't have to move on, and then they go on their mission. Now, actually, if Thanos is still alive or he's watching from death, that's another explanation for why he assaults the Avengers facility. If he catches wind of them doing this plan, he might just come right in and smash them at their home base. Either way, guys, that is the theory. I think Thanos will likely die very, very early on in this movie, even if he ends up coming back. I mean, otherwise, how do they go fight him and come back to Earth unscathed, and yet the gauntlet has still done the snap? I mean, it's the only thing that makes sense, and I know there's a lot of evidence and theories out there that run parallel to this, so I wanna know what you guys think about this. Let me know in the comment section below. No nerd card shout out today. I just wanna let you guys know again that this video was created with the help of Al Schuler. Al is always helping me out with these kind of ideas, writing up these videos, figuring this stuff out, and he has been our biggest Patreon supporter for the whole life of the channel. So thank you to Al. I'm gonna put his social media down below. Go give him some love. And as I always say, I hope you're having an awesome and a nerdy day, and I'll see you in the next video.